Welcome, ladies and gentlemen. It is 1 p.m. SLT on a Wednesday, and my Prozac is kicking in. But that can only mean it is time for DCWF Full Tilt. We got a special Wednesday edition. It's rare, but it happens. Special Wednesday edition of DCWF Full Tilt for you today. We got three great matches lined up, and who knows what could happen. Who knows what we're going to hear from. Want to make sure you mark your calendars for February 27th, DCWF WrestleFest 14. 14 years of DCWF, 14 years of professional wrestling. In Second Life, you didn't come here to hear me waffle on, so let's get right down to professional wrestling action. Ladies and gentlemen, this first match is scheduled for one fall. Introducing first from York, England, weighing in at 215 pounds, he is Marvelous Monty. Accomplished young athlete here getting ready to take on a veteran in the business from Las Vegas, Nevada, weighing it at 285 pounds. He is the gambler, Ace Nightfire. Referee Jack Chance checking in, making sure none of these guys brought a pistol to the ring. And we are ready to get this DCWF Full Tilt underway. Make sure you TP in your friends, TP in your enemies. Anybody that loves great professional wrestling action, we're doing it for you here this afternoon. Ace Nightfire, Marvelous Monty kicking this one off. Marvelous Monty looking to climb his way up the ladder. Ace Nightfire, former DCWF World Heavyweight Champion. And these two are going to go at it here. And don't forget to stick around. We got a couple great matches for you this afternoon. You do not want to miss the main event as Mama T takes on Horses Morrissey. Collar elbow tie up to start this one off, and we are underway. Kind of a contest of strength here. Ace Nightfire a little bit bigger than Monty. He has the leverage on something like this. Monty, on the other hand, quite quick, quite agile, quite squirrely. He can get around this ring like it's his job. As a matter of fact, it is his job. And this is a 10-minute time limit match. I had Ace Bonnie with that forearm club. Ace throwing some fist. And here's a drop kick to the head, followed up by a pin. One count, two count only, as Ace Nightfire manages to kick out of that one. And Marvelous Monty, big leg drop, adding insult to injury there. Ace Nightfire is down, and it is hard to get Ace Nightfire down. Big leg drop again from Marvelous Monty. He is on fire right now. Ace Nightfire taking the brunt of what Monty's got to offer. Monty's showboating for the crowd a little bit. Yeah, Marvelous Monty staying on the assault here, picking up a win over the former DCWF World Heavyweight Champion would be a huge, huge deal for this young athlete. And we have 6 minutes and 40 seconds left to go in this 10-minute time limit match. Irish whip. Ace Nightfire getting sent away. Ace Nightfire also looking to find his spot. DCWF WrestleFest, Ace Nightfire not going anywhere. Fires to with that big clothesline. Marvelous Monty not able to move the big guy, and Ace Nightfire is quickly going to take control of this match back. It's what he does. He can pick you up. He can beat on you. That clothesline was with authority. He's going to follow it up with a pin. One, two. Two count only. Oh, yeah, Marvelous Monty gets up and sweeps the leg. Not really having a problem with it. Taking Ace off of his feet. Grabs him by the leg now. Taking control back. This match is back and forth so far. Each man fighting for that control, for that leverage, for that upper hand. Marvelous Monty working a leg. Former DCWF World Heavyweight Champion. Good call there. Keep the big man down. Now he's got the figure four locked in. Referee's checking in to see if Ace wants to submit. We have 5 minutes and 25 seconds left to go in this opening match. 10-minute time limit. Ace Nightfire managing to work his way out of that, but he is favoring those legs right now. Marvelous Monty is, you can see his strategy. His strategy is crystal clear. He is going to work on those legs to keep the big man down. And Marvelous Monty can get up on the ropes, drop elbows, drop legs, drop knees, drop headbutts, whatever he needs to do. Ace Nightfire trying to make his way to his feet now, getting up. Ace Nightfire coming off the rope, charging in. Marvelous Monty off the rope as well. Fires through with that clothesline. Marvelous Monty gets there first. And he is going to keep the big man at bay. Sends him to the ropes once again. Ace Nightfire coming off the ropes. Fireman's carry. Ace Nightfire goes up and over. And we are down to 4 minutes in this 10-minute time limit match. And Marvelous Monty looking to put a win in a win column. But you don't put losses in a win column, right? And Marvelous Monty now running the ropes. Get a big short arm clothesline. Ace Nightfire goes down. And Marvelous Monty is all on fire today, and Ace Nightfire is having just a little bit of trouble getting his hands on him. Sends Ace Nightfire to the ropes once again. In the corner now, Marvelous Monty on the other side, measuring, looking to, like he's stalking his prey, looking to come up with his next move here. And Marvelous Monty with that big splash right in the corner. Referee trying to get the action out of the corner. We are at 3 minutes, and the knees are going to the midsection. Ace Nightfire taking the brunt of what Monty has to offer today. There's something about WrestleFest season, man. There's something about this time of year. Everybody turns the aggression up a little bit. They're a little bit meaner. They're a little bit nastier. These are mean, nasty people anyway. But everybody wants that spot coming up on February 27th. And Ace Nightfire now getting to his feet and shoving Monty out of the way. We'll see if Monty did enough damage to those legs. Big right hand from the former DCWF World Heavyweight Champion. And another big right hand. Ace Nightfire is, I think he's done taking it from Monty. Looks like he wants to dish it out now. We are 2 minutes away from the bell in this 10-minute time limit draw. Somebody's got to be able to pull this off. But there goes Monty with the whoosh, he calls it. Ace Nightfire goes down. Monty getting that pin. 1, 2. Ace Nightfire gets the shoulder up. Monty will not get the pin with 1:45 left to go in this 10-minute time limit match. And another short arm clothesline from Monty. Helping him up. A little sportsmanship. And another short arm clothesline. Marvelous Monty is giving no quarter to Ace Nightfire in this match right now. Ace Nightfire gets sent to the ropes. Eddie fires back with a huge drop kick. Marvelous Monty goes down. Ace Nightfire plants his feet right into the chest in midsection of Marvelous Monty. And Marvelous Monty dropped like a stone. We have 1 minute exactly right now left in this 10-minute time limit contest. Ace Nightfire, big discus clothesline. That big arm firing through Marvelous Monty goes down. Referee's checking on him. I think he might have gotten his head taken off. Ace Nightfire with the pin. 1, 2. No, 2 count only. And we are down to the last 30 seconds of this match. Can somebody pick it up? Can somebody pull something out of their hind end and grab a win here? And Marvelous Monty with the sweep kick. Marvelous Monty is on the ropes, trying to help himself up from that big drop kick, and we are down to 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. And it looks like this one will end in a time limit draw, waiting on the referee's official decision. But both of these men came out today, and neither one could get can quite get the other one's number. And this one will end in a time limit draw to open up DCWF Full Tilt on this special Wednesday edition. Referee calling it time limit draw now. And both of these men, they faced each other quite a bit. And there's a mutual respect there, absolutely, in my, no doubt about it in my mind. And they're going to have to come back another day. They have to try it again and see if... Yeah, they know each other so well. They got each other's moves down. What we got here? That music sounds familiar. It is the SLCW Women's Champion, Regan Blair, coming down. She's got that belt in the left hand and the shovel in the right. She is not scheduled in a match here tonight. We'll be right back. nonetheless, she is here, and she's just as proud. My kind of horror is not horror. No one's afraid of a painted monster. But that's about to change. A message comes via the grapevine. I get to pick my opponent for WrestleFest. A great, great opportunity for a bloodbath. I don't want the weakest of you that I could tear apart. No, I want the strongest I can find. I want someone who can walk through fire and brimstone. I want someone I can welcome to my nightmare. I want someone who can stand up to the monster. And when I find them at WrestleFest, they will say that I have shed innocent blood. What's blood for, if not for shedding? Because I am the writing on the wall, the sweet smell of blood, and I am still the SLCW champion. Be my victim. Ladies and gentlemen, this next match is scheduled for one fall. Introducing first, from Belfast, Northern Ireland, weighing in at 125 pounds, she is Emma Gray. She is Beth Rogers. Beth Rogers considers herself the personification of the 100 emoji, whatever that means. And referee Jack Chance calling this one as well, kicking it off right here. Emma Gray is the former SLCW Women's Champion. She was beaten by Regan Blair. And she is looking to get that spot back. Maybe, you know, Regan Blair will pick her. Beth also looking to get a slot at WrestleFest. So Regan Blair could, you know, she's watching this right now. I know she's in the back on the monitor studying this match, watching it, and seeing if she thinks that one of these people is somebody that she could take into the WrestleFest environment and have just the kind of match that we expect. Beth getting a little mouthy with Emma there. Emma not having it. And taking her down with the ground and pound. Pounding her right into the mat. And Beth with that kick. Taking Emma's legs out from under her. Beth able to get out from under there quick and put some distance there, buy some time. Beth claims that she wasn't aware that the match had started, but that bell's pretty damn loud. Again, there's a little trash talking going on. I don't know. Beth Rogers gets back in the ring. And Emma Gray gets up high with that drop kick. Beth going down. Emma Gray is not one to be amused by Beth's antics in the ring, and she is letting Beth know that. Sends her into the corner, just picks her up and just pretty much tosses her into the corner, and now she gets up and fist right to the forehead. Referee working to get it out of the corner and back into the center of the ring. Emma Gray complying with that front face lock, pretty much controlling Beth, bringing away she wants. Neck buster. Beth Rogers is in trouble. Here's the pin. One, two. Two count only. Beth gets that shoulder up. And, oh, that leg lariat after a stomp on the foot and a poke to the eye. Emma gets caught, pinned up, one. A one count only. Beth using some less than savory tactics, if you will. Oh, and a huge leg drop. Beth Rogers now on the defense and that sitting flip face buster. Beth Rogers on the offense, rather. And the pin, she's rolling her over. One, two, two count only. Emma gets that shoulder up. Beth Rogers now staying on the assault. Sends Emma Gray into the corner, Beth on the opposite corner, measuring, plotting her next move, and there she goes on the charge. Big, hard corner splash, planting Emma right in between herself and the turnbuckle. And now the foot on the throat there in the ropes, referee calling it one, two, and three, trying to get Beth out of the way. Referee, on top of this shit. I got no other way of putting it. Referee issuing Beth her warning. And again, measures and comes in. Emma Gray, however, trying to fight out with a drop kick. Beth caught it, but didn't go down, staggering a little bit, and now Emma Gray to the top rope, flying crossbody with the pin. One, two, two count. Beth Rogers gets that shoulder up. Emma Gray showing some signs of life here. She's fighting back. Oh, Emma Gray sends Beth to the ropes. Beth comes back with that bicycle kick. If do right, no can defend. That bicycle kick right to the face. But Emma manages to shake it off a little bit and get up. Beth Rogers now picks her up. Angel wings, drops her on her face. Here's the pin. One, two, two count. Evan Gray digging deep down, getting that shoulder up. Yes, I can believe it. Can you? That's all you got? Hey, you're in trouble then. Don't let Beth Rogers' antics in the ring dissuade you from the fact that she is a dangerous competitor. And there she goes, off the rope springboard, and connects. Emma Gray goes down. And maybe Beth was kidding when she said that was her best stuff. She's got plenty more in the repertoire, if you will. Single knee face buster, Emma Gray. In a whole lot of trouble here, and at the hands and at the mercy of Beth Rogers. Surfboard stretch, and it looks good, expertly applied in the center of the ring. Referee checking in to see if Emma Gray wants to let it go, wants to give it up and fight another day. Emma Gray not having it though. She is tough, and I don't think I've ever watched Emma Gray submit. Not that easily anyway. Emma Gray fighting out, putting some fists to the gut of Beth Rogers, and now planting a foot to the midsection. Emma Gray's creating an opening here, creating an opportunity. Sunset flip, there's the pin. One, two. Two count only. Beth Rogers managed to wiggle her way out of that sunset flip situation, but Emma Gray, only one on her feet for now. Emma Gray fighting from behind earlier to keep control of this match. Oh, the middle and a top rope DDT. Beth Rogers down, taking every last ounce of that DDT. Emma Gray to her feet. Like she's waiting for Beth to get up. It's like she's stalking her opponent. Beth to her feet. Emma Gray top rope now. Off the rope, Ireland's Fall connects. And Beth Rogers, that goes right back down to the mat. The pin, one, two, and three. Ladies and gentlemen, here is your winner, Emma Gray. Gentlemen, from Biker's Bayou, and again, we don't talk about how much she weighs, but it's somewhere between a buck 30 and a buck 50. She is Mama T.
You're doing all you can to get in them old jeans. You want that body back you had at 17. Well, baby, don't get down. Don't you worry about a thing, 'cause the way you fill them out, hey, that's all right with me. I don't want the girl you used to be. And if you ain't noticed, the key.
And her opponent, from Coventry, West Midlands, England, weighing in at 8 stone, 4 pounds. That's 116 U.S. She is classically trained. Horses Morrissey. You hit me once, I hit you back. You gave a kick, I gave a slap. You smashed a plate over my head, and I set fire to our bed. Oh, my black eye casts no shadow. Your red eye sees no blame. Your slaps don't stick, your kicks don't hit, so we remain the same. Blood sticks, sweat drips. Break the lock if it don't fit. A kick in the teeth is good for some. A kiss with a fist is Referee Jack Shantz sticking around for this main event, checking in with Mama T and Horses. Mama T, look, I don't know that there are many naturals in this business, but Mama T happens to be one of the few that have come through the halls of the DCWF, and she is taking on classically trained Horses Morrissey, the very first DCWF Women's Champion, thus the very first Women's Champion all of Second Life Professional Wrestling. Nobody is as decorated as Horses Morrissey in this business today. I promise you that. But she's kind of a bitch. Just saying. And here we go. Collar elbow tie up. Start this one off. Well, kind of. And Horses firing through with that kick to the midsection. Coming off the ropes, ducking under Mama's clothesline. Mama throws a big old clothesline. If she'd connected with that, she really might have put Horses on her ass. And Horses deciding to take a break. There she goes, taking a break. A little cardio on the outside of the ring. You got to get the cardio in, I guess. Jumping jacks are also good for the gluteus maximus muscles. And Horses, another one that is known for her antics. And Mama T, known for being all business. Referee counting on the count out though. Horses getting back in at the count of 9. And Mama T, all business. There she goes. Those fists of fury. Followed up by that big one, that bless your heart. That big spinning punch that she flattens Horses Morrissey right out. And Horses again rolls her way out of the ring. And she is crawling at ringside now. This is one of those things that you can't let Horses get in your head with this stuff. You gotta just keep your eye on her and get it when you get it. And Mama T not waiting around, comes to the outside. And the referee thinks Horses is on the other side there, but Mama T's caught her. And, wow. The referees are dumb. Yeah, Mama T bouncing Horse's head off the commentary desk. Big bicycle kick from Mama. The referee's going to go ahead and restart the 10 count. And she sends Horses back into the ring. Can't win the match on the outside of the ring. It's not that kind of show. Here's a leg hook. One, two. Two count. Horses gets that shoulder up. Mama T certainly is working her way up the top of the volcano. But, from me to you, you're going to have to put a little more work against Horses Morrissey. But, on the other hand, Mama T is staying on it. She is not giving up. It doesn't look like she's playing the head games with Horses either. And Horses stomping on Mama T's foot. Goes the top rope. Double axe handle connects right to the head of one Mama T, and Mama T goes down. Horses got the leg hooked up in. One, two. No, not three. Mama T gets that shoulder up. You're probably seeing birdies flying around. They had the little cartoon ones like... Orson Morrissey now stalking Mama T. Orson Morrissey will play those head games with you, but she is just as vicious and dangerous in the ring as anybody can be. And she's got her in a headlock, trying to see if you get the referee to ask to submit. Nobody's ever submitted to a headlock. But this is the first time for everything. Oh, and Mama T sent the rope and caught in the head scissors takedown. Horses Morrissey in control of this match once again. The jumping jacks keeping the cardio up. I don't know why you got to keep the cardio up. It's pretty good right now. Horses Morrissey's shoulder tackle from the rope, sending Mama T down to the mat. Horses Morrissey, no doubt about it, is about business today, even though she's having a little bit of fun with Mama T. I don't think she wants that too much. I don't think she wants to press the wrong button on Mama T. Them Bayou women can be kind of nasty. There's the big clothesline. Mama T fighting her way out now. Oh, big punches, big kicks. The here's your sweet tea, she calls it. The pin, one, two. Horses gets the shoulder up. Mama threw the kitchen sink at her. If Horses hanging on, though, Mama T's gonna have to dig a little bit deeper, a little bit harder. Horses, no, she don't want it no more. Horses trying to get her way out of it. Schoolboy roll up, the pin. Mama T kicks out. And both of these ladies to their feet right now. Horses Morrissey. Oh, up and down the crucifix pin. Here's the count. One, two, three. Ladies and gentlemen, here is your winner, Horses Morrissey.
You hit me once, I hit you back. You gave a kick, I gave a slap. You smashed.